Hello everyone and welcome to a new vlog. I'm actually in the middle of filming a few different vlogs right now, so I wanted to start this vlog just as like a regular vlog outside of those vlogs. Anyway, so I think this will go over a few weeks, but yeah. I have been doing some stunning reading this month and I still have a lot of books that I want to read before October. So this morning I just started June by Frank Herbert, which is obviously a classic, and I really want to read this before the movie comes out. This is actually the movie tie-in edition, which is stunning. Like, I love the cover. Like, exactly Timothy looking gorgeous, exactly Zendaya looking gorgeous. Like, yeah, it's just stunning. So yeah, I started this morning. I actually read the first few chapters on my channel as a YouTube live and it was so fun. And I loved what I read. Like, the writing is amazing. There have been some stunning lines. Honestly, I need to go back and annotate because I was reading on live and obviously didn't want to like pause and underline things. Yeah, like, wow, I'm really enjoying it. I was a bit nervous just because I've heard that it is quite dense, but actually someone said in the live that people don't realize how approachable the text is, and I completely agree with that. Like, the writing is very easily digestible, and you know, obviously there are a few different terms that I was not aware of, but I feel like you're not thrown into the deep end. Like, you obviously have some terms that you're like, oh, what does that mean, but you're slowly learning things in a really interesting way. So yeah, I'm really enjoying this so far. I'm actually thinking to switch to the audiobook though, just because I have a lot of other books I need to physically read, and also I have some journal videos and stuff to film, so I thought it could be nice to listen to the audiobook while I do that. Exactly to this book right now. But I also have an exciting package to open. I am so excited. Like, okay. So I've already opened the actual box, but I haven't opened the product, and yeah. So I got a Kindle Paperwhite, which I'm literally so happy about because I've been reading more ebooks on my iPad, and Caitlin and Jamie have a Kindle, and obviously a lot of the times when we're reading together on FaceTime, they're using their Kindle. I've been like, oh, maybe I should get a Kindle, but I'm like, oh, I don't need one because I have an iPad. But then they were telling me like all the benefits of a Kindle. It's lighter, it's thinner, the battery lasts like weeks. It's waterproof, it is much easier on the eyes, etc. So I was like, you know what? I think I'm gonna get one, especially because I've been reading more ebooks and I want to continue reading more ebooks. So I'm so excited about this. And also I got a stunning pink one. I will show you. I have a matching one with Caitlin now. She actually films like a Kindle video, so I'll leave that link below if it's uploaded. I am so excited. Oh, this packaging exactly. I'll also have this model linked below in my description if you wanna check it out. Caitlin's already got it and she's loving it, and I'm just so excited. Like, it's beautiful. Oh yeah, I love some satisfying packaging. Oh my god, it's literally so light. This is so exciting. This is, I actually haven't stopped thinking about this ever since I ordered it. And then it came a few days ago and I was like, should I open it? But I wanted to open it on camera, so. I'm so excited. Wow. Look at this. I just love the dusty pink. I was tossing up between the pink and the black and I was like, you know what? I want to have my pink moment. And I did buy some stickers off Redbubble to decorate, but they haven't arrived yet, so I'm gonna wait for that and then I'll decorate it and I'll show you how I decorated it. But yeah, I love it. High resolution 300 ppi display, built-in light, weeks of battery life. Also, you can do dark mode. Caitlin was telling me all the features, so I'm like, yep. Also, ever since I knew I was getting this, when I've been reading like a really heavy book, I'm kind of like, this is so heavy. Like, I'm suddenly noticing how heavy some books are. Obviously, I'll never get over physical reading. Like, I love physical reading, but I definitely want to read some more ebooks. So this is stunning. I don't know why I'm trying to convince you how good ebooks are. Obviously, a lot of people know. I haven't really been an ebook reader over the years, but I'm finally in my moment, in my Kindle moment. Exactly. I got 3 free months of Kindle Unlimited, and look at all my books so far. Stunning. Anyway, I'm going to go back to doing some work stuff. But later on, hopefully I'll film my journal video and I will continue listening to, well, I'll start the June audiobook and continue from where I left off. Yep. Thank you. Hi. Interesting. Hey, so I finished filming my journal video and I switched to the audiobook for June, which I'm so happy about because the audiobook is stunning. Like, full cast. Exactly. And it also has like background music and it's just really atmospheric and I'm just really, really vibing it. And honestly, like, I'm just so into the story. Like, I'm just so happy that I'm reading this. So I'm on page 51. Yeah, like I said, can't wait to continue. Honestly, it was such a vibe, me listening to the audiobook while I was journaling. I was like, oh, exactly. Especially because there was a moment in the day where I was not thriving and then I was like, oh, this is what life's about. So it was stunning. But now I'm gonna do a Fortnite stream with Caitlin, Kevin, and Jamie. I'm currently on FaceTime with them. Do you guys wanna quickly say hello?
Yeah. Kevin.
Look at the besties.
Hello. We're just talking about Met Gala looks.
Hello, so today is going to be a big day of editing. Basically, I'm just gonna spend the whole day editing. But I thought I would open this because I got a little prezzy. Oh. Why am I gonna cry? Hey Chloe, just wanted to say that your videos have brought me so much joy in lockdown. Hope you're staying well from now. Honestly, I woke up in a really sad girl mood so I could cry. Oh my god, exactly. Camp Slaughter, Sergio Gomez. Actually, I've been really looking forward to reading this and perfect timing because October is just around the corner, so I'll definitely be reading this in October. Basically, this is a horror and I absolutely love this cover. And it says, this deep in the woods, danger can be lurking anywhere. It's a local legend. No one is sure if Camp Slaughter place is real or not. But a group of college kids renting out a cabin deep in the woods of Pennsylvania will soon realize the truth. They'll realize the danger too, or rather the cannibal out in the woods will bring the danger to them. I just love a classic horror book set in the woods. And there's a group of young adults together, like, just so fun. So I'm very excited for this. And thank you so much, Mel. Like, wow. Oh, yeah. No. Oh my god, stunning! Oh my- Oh my god, exactly! Hey Chloe! Whoa! Oh, freak.
Hey!
You look so funny, it looks like this is your face and this is your body. So we're just hanging out. Chloe, Chloe. We're just hanging out. Why does this look so funny?
Scared me.
So look at Ryan. Okay, so, oh, wait, wait, wait. I got a package. So I thought I'd open it because I'm very excited. Beasts of Prey by Ayana Gray. Oh, this is set at a night zoo. Stunning. Brand new fantasy adventure. The reason I actually wanted to do this clip, well, I have a little bit of hot chocolate. I ordered some stickers for my Kindle, like I mentioned, I think. And they came. So I wanted to show you them and also decide which stickers I'm gonna put in my Kindle. By the way, I know it looks disgusting. Like, let's just go with it. Yeah. Actually, jokes. I take that back. We're too hard on ourselves. We need to stop talking to ourselves like that. It's fine. We've got stunning Tommy. We've got stunning Timothée Chalamet. We've got normal people, Marianne Connell. It's not like this with other people. I got another one that says it's not like this with other people because it's one of my favorite quotes. We've got this stunning girl crying. We've got another Marianne Connell. We've got some quotes in the Night Circus. We've got another normal people one. Little Women, Night Circus, Spanish Love Deception, Cute Bunny Reading. This has Caitlin vibes and I wanted to get it for Caitlin to represent Caitlin. And Daisy Jones, another Daisy Jones. The monologue from Gone Girl. Drink Me tag, Daisy Jones quote, Evelyn Hugo, exactly. Daisy Jones once again, and another Daisy Jones. So I got obviously quite a few stickers. I'm obviously not gonna put them all on my Kindle, but I also got them for my 2022 reading journal. So I have lots of options and also just for other things. It's very hard to choose what I'm gonna put on my Kindle. Like, I was on FaceTime with Caitlin and I was like kind of stressing out. Like, I nearly started crying. Like, obviously it's a joke, but like, I don't know what to do. Like, there's just too many stunning options. So I'll show you what options I'm thinking. So obviously I wanna cover up this disgusting logo, but I don't wanna put too many stickers on because I like the pink. So I'm kind of thinking, you know, I could go for like this vibe, like that's stunning, or this vibe, and then I could even do like this vibe with one of these quotes. So I was thinking I could do like welcome back to the night court, because then it's like welcome back to, you know, the world of reading. Like, that's stunning. So that's a really strong contender, honestly. I could also do my stunning Timothy Chalamet moment. Obviously normal people love it. I love how there's like the dash of pink in the cheek, so then it kind of ties in. Oh, see, okay, I think my main options are this or this with the quote. And it's just like, obviously I can change it, like it's not like I'm committing to this forever, but it's just kind of stressful, like I don't know, because I love them both. Like, I think I'm slightly vibing more with this, like welcome back to, yeah, okay, I'm just gonna do it. Been such a girl boss today though. I edited my entire bookshelf tour video, which took, yeah, the whole day, and I finished at like 7 p.m. and I was like, yeah, exactly, I felt so accomplished. Now I'm in bed and I'm really happy with how my Kindle looks. Also, Equivalent Exchange is the book that I DNF'd, so yeah, I didn't like that. I'm reading a different book for a different vlog that I'm filming, and I'm going to continue reading that tonight. But before I read that, I wanted to read a cute little graphic novel to make the most of my Kindle Unlimited membership. And I just feel like it because I'm not particularly enjoying the other book that I'm reading. So I'm thinking to just scroll through and let's see, you know?
Ew, not Rick and Morty.
Okay. I think I'm going to read Princess, Princess Ever After by Katie O'Neill, who is the author of The Tea Dragon Society. And you know, I love those graphic novels. And it's on Kindle Unlimited. So I think I'm going to read that cheeky little 58 pages before I read my other book. And I'm going to watch Kat Karras's new vlog while I read. Hello, so it is the next day. I read Princess, Princess Ever After last night, and it was really cute, a really fast read. Obviously so cute to have like a children's story about two princesses who fall in love, like obviously so cute, so needed. But you know, it didn't have like a huge impact on me or anything. So I gave it 3 stars, but definitely an enjoyable, cute time. Also, I realized I forgot to update you on June. So I have been slowly listening to more of the audiobook. I'm on page 71 now, still really enjoying the vibes, enjoying the story, enjoying the characters, enjoying the writing. So excited to make more progress, but I'm also not like absolutely itching to continue reading. Like, I'm not like, oh my gosh, I need to know what happens next. I'm just kind of like enjoying my time slowly reading it. But tomorrow I'm getting my second dose of the vaccine, which is really exciting. So I think I'm gonna have like a chill day and hopefully film some journal videos. So I'm planning to listen to more of the audiobook then. Anyway, I'm actually going to unbox the August Furley box, which is very exciting. So if you don't know, I am a Furley rep, so thank you so much to Furley for sending me this box. And you can use the code Chloe for a discount off your first box in a monthly subscription plan. I'm in a really weird mood today, like honestly the past few days. I've just been so emotional. Like, I will literally cry at the stupidest thing. Yesterday when I was editing, I had the little prince playing like on the other monitor when I was editing, and I literally teared up so many times. And obviously like it makes sense because that's a stunning movie and it has some really stunning moments. I've been watching Love Island season 5 and I've been crying at so many things there. Like, even if it's a really simple cute moment, I literally just start crying. Anyway, let us get into it. So the theme for, oh great, the theme for August is love struck. So honestly, I might cry. I just love seeing people in love, you know. Oh, it's Sex Education season 3. I watched a few episodes with Caitlin and it's literally amazing, like so good, and I would have watched the whole thing, but we're waiting for Kevin, so hopefully I can watch my episode soon. But yeah, I have like nearly teared up at so many moments in Sex Education, like it's just stunning. Anyway, so the first item is this Caraval stamp pin. Absolutely love that design. I love how it's like a stamp. Then we have this stunning tray. And I was actually thinking this morning that I wanted a tray for my bedroom because I wanted to put some of my stuff. Anyway, so this is stunning. And it says, it wasn't the end, it was a better beginning. Oh, I love that quote. Oh, that's a quote from Cemetery Boys, which I'm actually planning to read in October. Need to film my October TBR soon, actually. But anyway, stunning. Oh yes, there's going to be 2 books in this box, I forgot. Wow, this is stunning. This is After Love by Tanya Byrne. Not even death will tear them apart, and it looks like it's two stunning goats. How beautiful is that cover with the pink edges? So this has an exclusive cover, sprayed edges, and a digital signature. And it's a beautiful sapphic love story about a connection strong enough to challenge death itself. So, the main character Ash gets an invitation from the afterlife to join a clan of fierce girl reapers who take the souls of the city's dead to await their fate. And Ash can't forget her first love, Poppy, and she'll do anything to see her again, dead or alive. Oh my god, exactly. Perfect for my romance readathon. Definitely going to read this for one of my romance readathons. Like, exactly. Okay, then we have this cute pin banner. Honestly, I have way too many pin banners, but love that design. Oh, and it's inspired by These Violent Delights. Okay, then we have the Benson game. The world is wild with untamed things. And this quote is from A River of Royal Blood. Okay, then we have the monthly character tarot cards. So we have Ace of Pentacles and Two of Pentacles. And these are characters from Caraval. Okay, so time for the book. Well, the other book. Oh, beautiful orange. Okay, stunning, stunning, stunning. Oh, wow. Ooh, look at this cover. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at, yeah. That is beautiful. Wow. These Hollow Vows by Lexi Ryan. Oh, yeah, yeah. Wow, this, yeah. Okay, stunning character art. That person kind of has Reese vibes. Stunning design on the naked book. Oh, we've got fun map. It's also signed by the author. So this is apparently a sexy action-packed fantasy about a girl who is caught between two treacherous fairy courts. You know, I love a fae story. This definitely gives me like Court of Thorns and Roses vibes. And hopefully it's a really fun romance fantasy time. There's also this stunning character art of the main character, I believe. The monthly bookmark. And yeah, if I didn't say this is a Fairyloot exclusive edition, they just know how to do a stunning exclusive edition. So anyway, I'm going to go back to reading my book for my other reading vlog, but I will talk to you soon. Okay, hello. I'm about to go live on Twitch to do some reading and stuff, but I wanted to do a quick update to say last night I reread Everyone's an Alien When You're an Alien Too, and just stunning. Like, this is literally my third time reading this book because I love it so much. And I was having a sad girl moment, and this really just reminds me what life's about and how when you're sad, it's actually a good thing because you're human and, you know, you should live in that moment of sadness. Anyway, I just love this book so much, and my friend Tess was here and we read it together on the floor over there, and it was such a cute moment, honestly, like such a highlight. And this was her first time reading it, and just reading it with her was just such a stunning moment. And I just love this book so much. Honestly, thinking of getting a tattoo from this book, like, I just love it. Yeah, so I read that last night. Need to update my journal and stuff, but yeah, I'm gonna go live, and I'm actually starting another book, but that is for a separate vlog, so talk to you later. Oh, and I got fully vaccinated yesterday. Hello everyone. I am in such a good mood and I'm very excited to be here right now and to be talking with you all and to do some reading. I'm gonna be starting the Song of Achilles.
What's your address?
Hello, I'm currently currently filming a day in the life video for my Patreon, but I thought I'd quickly pop in to say that I have made more progress with June. I'm on page 105 now, still listening to the audiobook, still really enjoying the book. I think this will take me a long time to read though, just because I'm not really getting the pull to read it like really quickly. Like I'm not like, oh my gosh, I need to know what happens right now. So I'm not in a rush to finish this book, but I'm definitely enjoying my time and the audiobook, like I said, is amazing. So I listened to more of that while I was getting ready this morning. And last night, I actually started reading Hands Down by Mariana Zapata. I'm obviously reading this on my Kindle, and this is the next Mariana Zapata book that me and Caitlin decided to read because we want to buddy read like all her books together. And so far, it's really fun. I'm on 9%, and basically the main girl is forced to see this guy who she hasn't seen in ages, and she used to be in love with him, and he's now this like famous rugby player, I think. Some sort of sports player. But yeah, love the vibe so far. I am a bit nervous though because Caitlin messaged me saying that it's not the vibe, so I'm a bit nervous. Like, I know it's not going to be as good as the other ones I've read by Mariana Zapata, because how can it be? Like, obviously, All Roads Lead Here, From the Cove with Love, The Wall of Winpigamy, like, those are all stunning. And I know that a lot of people say that those are, like, her best ones. So I wasn't expecting Hands Down to be in the same level, but I'm hoping it'll still be a fun, good time. So I'm still going to finish it, but I'm actually going to end the vlog here. Obviously, see you in a new vlog soon, but I really hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget, if you're looking for more content from me, I have a Patreon where I upload extra content, like extra reading vlogs. We do a monthly live show, we do a monthly buddy read, etc. I have all my socials linked below, including my Twitch, which is twitch.tv/gamewithchloe, which is where I stream games and just chatting. So I hope you're all having a good day or night, and I'll see you in my next video.